Hello friends, so today we will discuss queuing model. I have written all the formulas of queuing model here and I will share this PDF to Telegram channel. So join the Telegram channel from link in the description. So today first we will discuss all the formula and second we will discuss all the sums of modules. So let's get started. If we talk about formulas, you have to remember all the formulas to solve the queuing model problems. So to remember all the formula, you have to write at least 2 to 3 times all the formulas. So it will be easy for you to remember all the formulas. Without formula, you can't solve the sum. So let's move forward to our first formula. Our first is lambda. What is lambda? Average customer arrival rate. For example, if we take example, in 1 hour, 12 customers are coming. So what is mean? Average arrival rate is 12. Our second formula is mu. What is mu? Customer service rate. For example, in 1 hour we are able to serve the 10 customers. For example, we are taking 10 customers. So what is means? Average service rate is 6 minutes. In one customer is taking 6 minutes. So in 60 minutes, how much customer we can serve is 10 customers. Our third formula is average number of customers in line, means how many customers are in line. So for that you have to means LQ. LQ means lambda square divided by mu into bracket mu minus lambda. Our fourth formula is average number of customer in system. Here is the in line or queue, here is the in system. So average number of customer in system. So LS means lambda divided by mu minus lambda. You have to remember LQ and LS also, because in next formula it will be helpful to you. Our next formula is average number of customer waiting in line. Here is the customer in line and here is the waiting in line. Waiting in line. So waiting may be in hours or minutes. In this formula we will get hours, so we have to convert hour into minutes. So waiting in queue means WQ means LQ divided by lambda. What is LQ? LQ is here lambda square divided by mu into bracket mu minus lambda. So LQ divided by lambda. What is LQ? So LQ means we have written LQ n divided by whole divided by lambda. Our next formula is average number of customer waiting in system. Waiting in system, it will be in hours or minutes. So by this formula we will get hours, so we have to convert hour into minutes. So WS means WQ plus 1 divided by mu. What is WQ? Here WQ is written LQ divided by lambda. In usually question LQ will be given, so it will be not difficult for you. LQ divided by lambda plus 1 divided by mu. So our next formula is system utilization. Means if we take example ki average customer arrival rate is 10 and we can able 12 customers. So how much capacity we have used? So 10 divided by 12, that much is your system utilization. P is equal to lambda divided by m multiplied by mu. What is m? So for example, we take cashier. So one cashier may be serve 12 customer. If we take 2 m, so it will be 24, but average customer arrival rate is same, so it will be our utilization will be decreased. So our next formula is idle time. If we take key 10 customer are arriving and we can able to serve 12 customers, so how much time we will be idle for that? So 1 minus p we can calculate by this formula. Our next formula is probability of 0 units in system. So p0 is equal to 1 minus lambda divided by mu, and our next formula is probability of n units in system. So p0, we have to compulsorily calculate p0 first and then lambda divided by mu into n. How much units is given, you have to write here, so you will get the answer. So let's start with question number 7. But before starting, I must say, read the formula and remember the formula, because it is an important to remember the formula. So remember the formula and write the formula 2 to 3 times, so it will be easy for you to solve the any sum. So let's start with question number 7. I have written in short question number 7 here. So what question number 7 said? Average customer arrival rate is 16 and customer service rate is 3 minutes per customer. So what is it? Lambda is equal to 16 and mu is equal to, if one customer is taking 3 minutes, so in 60 minutes how much customer we can serve? So 60 divided by 3 is equal to 20 customer we can serve in 1 hour. So our mu is 20 and our lambda is 16. So our, let's start with question number 7. A says, what are the arrival and service rate? So arrival rate is lambda is equal to 16 and service rate is equal to 20 customer, means mu is equal to 20. Second question is, compute the average number of customer being served at any time. So how much customer we can serve? How much customer we can serve? So answer is, our total capacity is 20 customer and customer arising is 16. So if we take how much customer we can serve, so 16 divided by 20, so 0.8 customer we can serve at any time. C said, LQ is given is equal to 3.2. I am writing in short LQ, means what is LQ? I have in formula written here, LQ means average number of customer in line is, LQ means 3.2. So LQ is equal to, if we write formula here, LQ is equal to lambda divided by mu, mu minus lambda. So in that our first question is, sorry for that. Our first question is average number of customer in system. So our first answer is average number of customer in system. So what is formula for average number of customer in system? I have written here average number of customer in system is lambda divided by mu minus lambda. So average number of customer is equal to average number of customers is equal to lambda divided by mu minus lambda. What is lambda? 16. Mu is equal to 20 and 16. So 60 divided by 4. The average number of customer in line equal to 4 customers. Our second question is, what is second question? I have written here average time customer waiting in line. So what is waiting in line? Formula for that, waiting in line. So formula is WQ is equal to LQ divided by lambda. And what is LQ? LQ is given here. LQ is equal to 3.2. So 3.2 divided by lambda is what? Lambda is 20. Okay. Sorry. Lambda is 16. So 3.2 divided by 16. If we do 3.2 divided by 16. So 0.2. And I have already said it is in hours. So how much time? So 0.2 is equal to 60. So 0.2 multiplied by 60 is equal to 12 minutes. So how much customer in line is 16? And our next question is average number of customer in system. So what is formula for that? Average number of customer in system. So LQ plus 1 divided by mu. So LQ we have already calculated. What is LQ? We have calculated 12 minutes. So 12 plus 1 divided by mu. So 1 divided by mu is equal to 12 plus 1 is divided by mu is equal to 20. So 12 minutes. Remember that it is in minutes. So 1 divided by 20 is equal to 0.05 hours multiplied by 60 minutes. So 3 minutes. So total 15 minutes. We have to calculate all the answer in minutes. So our third question is already solved. So our next question is system utilization for M, 1, 2 and 3. What is formula for system utilization? I have written here. System utilization means question D is system utilization. If M is equal to 1, so M is equal to 1, so system utilization P is equal to lambda divided by M multiplied by mu. If M is equal to 1, so lambda is 16 divided by M is equal to 1 divided by 20. So 16 divided by 20 if we do, then it is 0.8 system utilization, or 80%, whatever it is. M is equal to 2, so P is equal to lambda divided by 2 multiplied by mu. Mu have already calculated 20, so 16 divided by 40. So what is 60 divided by 40? 60 divided by 40 if we do is equal to 0.4 and M is equal to 3. So P is equal to lambda divided by 3 multiplied by 20. So 60 divided by 60, 16 divided by 60 if we do. So 60 divided by 60 to 0.27. So this is the system utilization. You may do for M3, M4, whatever it is given in question. So I hope you got answer of question number 7 and understood it. Now let's start with question number right. Page number 19, I have written here in short question. Average arrival time is 15 customer and 1 customer is taking 3 minutes. So let's start first question, system utilization. What is the formula for system utilization? Formula for system utilization is equal to lambda divided by m multiplied by mu. Here m is not given, so we have to assume 1. So our answer is system utilization P is equal to, what is formula, lambda divided by m multiplied by mu multiplied by 100. If we don't do 100, that is okay, not an issue. So what is lambda? Lambda is given here 15. M is equal to, assume to be 1, because only one cashier, whatever it is, 1 is there. So what is mu? Mu we have to calculate. So mu is equal to 1 customer is equal taking 3 minutes. So in 60 minutes, how much customer we can serve? So our answer will be 20 customers. So our mu will be 20. So 15 divided by 20, if we do 15 divided by 20, answer will be 0.75 or 75%, whatever it is, you may write. Our second question is percentage of idle time agent will be, percentage of time the agent will be idle. So how much time agent is idle? So if he is working for 75% time, so how much time he is idle? It is normal 25% time he is idle, because our total capacity is 20 customer and customer arrival rate is 15. If we do 4 divided by 20, then also you may get answer 0.2 customer. That is customer, not on percentage, remember that. Our third is waiting in line, means how much customer waiting in line. So formula for that is customer, average number of customer waiting in line is lambda square divided by mu into bracket mu minus lambda. So we have to apply this formula. LQ is equal to lambda square divided by mu minus lambda. What is lambda? We have already given here 15. So 15 square divided by mu is given 20. 20 minus 15. So what is 15 square? If we calculate, 50 square is 225 divided by 20, and 15 minus 20 minus 15 is equal to 5. So 225 divided by 100 is 2.25 customer. Remember that it is customer, not on time or anything, it is customer. Our next question is spend time in system, average time spent in a system. So what is formula for every time spent in system? So average time waiting in system, formula is WQ plus 1 divided by mu. What is WQ? We can substitute WQ is equal to LQ divided by mu. So LQ we have already calculated. Our fourth question is LQ we already calculated 2.25, and divide by mu we have to do. So what is mu? Sorry, divide by lambda. What is lambda? Is 15 plus 1 divided by mu. What is mu? We have already calculated, it is in our. So 2.25 divided by 15, 0.15 plus 1 divided by 20, 0.05 plus 0.15 is equal to 0.2 hours. Remember that it is in hours. So multiply by 16 is equal to 12 minutes. Our answer is 12 minutes. Our next question is probability of zero customer. So what is formula for probability of zero customer? Probability of zero customer is equal to P0 is equal to P0 is equal to 1 minus lambda divided by mu. 1 minus lambda we have calculated, given is 15, and calculated mu is equal to 20. So 1 minus 50 divided by 20, we can calculate 0.75. So 1 minus 0.75, so 0.25. And next is for probability of 4 customer, 4 unit means 4 units in line. So what is probability of n units in system formula. So probability of n units in system is equal to p0. We have to compulsorily calculate p0, then later on apply this formula. So for customer is equal to p4 is equal to p0 lambda divided by mu into n. So what is p0? We have already calculated 0.25, lambda is 15 divided by mu is 20, n here n is equal to 4. So 0.25, so 15 divided by 20, 1, 2, 3 and 4 multiplied by 0.25. so 0 point, here I am writing answer directly, 0.079 units. It is probability, not unit, sorry, it is probability. Okay, so I think your both the question is solved. If you want solve next two question, then let me know in comment box. I will solve that and upload the video and share with your friends and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.